Hey, and greetings from Knoxville, Tennessee on Sunday, August 8th, 2021. The black milk snake. So you are doing your research or you have decided that this is what you want. This is a three-year-old. She is my 2018 hatchling. Just shed yesterday. Nice, full, complete shed. And you can see the enclosure she's in. Over here is my 2020 male, and I'll get to that in a moment. The reason I mention that full complete shed is these guys come from high elevation, misty, rainy forests. Costa Rica and Panama mountains, several thousand feet in the air. So I can keep them on aspen, because I can keep the humidity pretty high in here. Certainly not damp, but just with this water bowl, that is enough to where when I lift the lid off to feed or clean, I can feel the difference in humidity. And again, her sheds are perfect in here. If you do have a higher ventilated enclosure, you might want to go to cocoa bark or some kind of substrate that can hold humidity, cypress, what have you. I do not keep heat in these enclosures right now. I do keep them in my office, and during the summer, I keep my vent closed in here so the AC doesn't run. And they stay a pretty constant 75 degrees, which is right in the middle of what you want. You want anywhere from 72 to 78 degrees. If you do have an 80 degree hot spot, but they can retreat to the cool side, that's okay as well. But that's the beauty of these guys. If you have a warmer area of your house, you don't have to worry about heat at all. In fact, if you keep these at a constant ambient temperature of 85 degrees, that's not gonna be good for them. So my girl, you can see excellent temperament on these milk snakes. A lot of milk snakes are very jumpy, especially as babies. But these black milks, they just, they've got a confidence that just keeps them very, very easy to handle. And right here is my male. Again, he's a yearling. Just starting to have his black overtaking his red. His white is nearly gone. There is a little bit there you can see. But, I mean, take a look at that. He is not squirmy. He's not racing to get away from me. Hey, bud. Very, very handleable snake. Focus a little bit there. There we go. Now, you're going to pay more for these guys than you will a corn snake or a California king or even a Sinaloan or Nelson milk snake. But what you get is a very confident snake, a very hardy snake, and one that you just don't have to put as much money into as far as care because of the heating. As long as you do have a room that doesn't get too much above 78 degrees. Now, if my office does dip down into the 60s in the winter, I just open my vent up and it's, again, perfect temperature in here. I do have a window right here that will heat my office up in the winter. So that makes housing these guys very, very easy. Now, this is Atlas. This is a 113 quart, I believe, Sterilite tub. And Georgia is my female. She's about to outgrow this tub. So I may look at a Christmas tree tub or something for her. They eat once a week. This guy, Atlas, is on small adult mice. Georgia is on jumbo retired breeders. And she'll be on small rats probably within the next year. And hopefully in another year or two, I will breed these guys. But they're slow to sexually mature. 3 to 4 years is what you're looking at. And he's coming up on 2. So I think he needs another year out of him. So if you think corn snakes are the perfect snake, and I believe that they are, these guys are perfect plus one, simply for the fact that they do not need heat. They will get much bigger than a corn snake, so you've got to plan on a large enclosure. I would say 4 feet is the minimum for an adult. You're going to see 5, sometimes 6 feet out of these guys, and they are beefy. So if you have any questions on the black milk, please feel free to comment and ask. I do my best to respond to every comment. Sometimes I might miss one, and for that I apologize. But I sure do love the black milk. He's about to stretch out. So this will be good. I'll be able to get a good length estimation on him. All right. Well, have a good rest of your Sunday. From Atlas, Georgia, and me, I thank you for watching. We will see you next time.